Welcome to the Digging Deeper podcast, brought to you by New Hope Church. My name is Matt, and I am so very excited to dive into today's episode, specifically because I'm sitting down with people just like me. And I don't mean our pastors, they're awesome too, but I am sitting down with New Hope's tech team, and this is close to my heart because I'm a geek at heart. And I'm so excited to hear a little bit about why you guys are here, why you guys do what you do, what is so fun about being in tech ministry. But before we do that, though, we really do need to go around the room and introduce everybody, because this is your first time, I think, for most of you, being on the podcast. So I'm actually going to start on the side here. So can you tell us a little bit about who you are, what you do as a day job, and how you serve on the tech team?
Okay, my name is Peter Sawatsky. I am a retired maintenance guy from General Motors, and I just kept working. I work at Arts Tools now, selling and repairing tools. I'm currently a camera operator and on training for sound, so hopefully I can do a good job on that too.
Awesome, thank you.
I'm Sydney Barrett. I am a student at Eden High School, and on the tech team, I've done lyrics in the past and I've been on camera as well.
Yeah, and I'm Ephraim Jansen. I'm currently in grade 11 at Eden, which means exam season. Woo woo.
That's a sorry. Positivity.
Yeah. I mostly do lights. I've done cameras. I enjoy anything doing it, but yeah, mostly on lights.
Awesome. Thanks, man.
I'm Len Schoblad. I am a freelance event director, produce and direct events from Toronto all the way down this way. Mm-hmm. And I am the camera director / switcher for the cameras.
That's right.
For our productions on Sundays.
Beauty.
You really do two jobs.
Yeah.
Every Sunday.
It's true. I had to remind you.
It's unreal. Yeah, and you just have to teach me that.
Get the lingo, Dave.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead, buddy.
My name is David Braun. I get to be a director at Limo Gardens. I'm serving there with our team of managers, helping manage operations. And here at New Hope, I get to lead our tech team and audio and camera or whatever happens.
That's
to come
right.
Up,
so. Yeah. You're kind of a catch-all. Whatever needs to be done.
It's a lot of fun.
That's right. Garage door opener. Like it's really everything. So
helping move chairs so they don't bump into my camera table.
Yeah. My favorite is when you're like balancing the iPad with all of the sound stuff on it and moving chairs at the same time. It's an impressive feat.
Multitasking.
That's right.
But not guys, doing my best mix at that time.
No. It's good. Sorry. But no, guys, thank you so much for joining me on this episode. Really excited to dive into this. And I'm not going to beat around the bush. Let's just jump right into it. What's your favorite part of serving on the New Hope Tech Ministry team? Go ahead, Ephraim. Why don't you start us out?
I would have to say the breakfast that the staff here make for us. I know for me, it's a big thing because I would, serve a few services and I started to get hungry. And then, what better thing to do? Go to the kitchen, grab some food.
That's right.
Sit up in the tech booth, talk to people and eat breakfast. It's just nothing better than that.
That's spoken like a true high school student right there.
Right. Yeah.
Love those, those are made by our wonderful volunteer teams.
That's true, actually. Yeah, our volunteers slug away every week and make sure we have food.
A rotating group of wonderful people. Thank you.
You got it. Absolutely. Go ahead, Sid.
I think for me, my favorite part of serving on tech team would be kind of like learning the different techie things. I've always kind of enjoyed computers and like video games and like anything really involved with tech. And so kind of getting to learn that and serve Jesus while learning is pretty cool.
Yeah. It's neat when you can take your passions and turn them over and give them back to God, right? Yeah. That's a pretty sweet thing. Len?
Well, as being the older statesman maybe in this group, for me, it was... I've got about 30 years production experience, and I hate to say that number out loud, but I do. But for me, when Dave first took me to the tech table, what I found was astounding and wonderful was, as he introduced me to the people who were volunteering, he happened to say, "This is so-and-so grade 7, so-and-so grade 8, this is so-and-so grade 10. Mm-hmm. And I was astounded that there is that amount of responsibility on the youth.
Yeah.
Let alone to take a look at what they do and how much they can excel at that age, to me is outstanding. So for me, it's a great opportunity for me to sort of teach the younger generation now on what the technology is that we do have and more importantly, what we could do with it going forward. So for me, it was just to see the ages and the responsibility and the actual performance and execution for a lot of the kids, for lack of a better term, and how professional and responsible that they were, let alone they were kicking butt while they were doing it. And it was pretty outstanding to see.
Yeah, it's funny when you say that, because I'm reminded back to like when we started doing online when COVID hit. I mean, it was all teenagers.
Yeah.
They ran everything. I mean, obviously directed by you, Dave, and stuff like that. But I mean, it was teens running all of our, you know, online production that people were seeing every week. And for a lot of people, that's still their first exposure to New Hope.
Mm-hmm.
And that's pretty incredible that our youth get to be on the front line of making a safe space,
yeah,
right? By producing to the quality that they do. So
every Sunday, probably two of our three camera operators are young people.
That's right. Yeah, under the age of 18.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Often younger than 18.
Yeah, often much younger. I tried to take one of, you know, Peter and put him in, so we have a rock there, and then we got some other people, right? So
that's right.
Not that Peter's old, but you know, he's I wouldn't say young people anymore.
Experience. That's right. Experience.
Speaking of Peter.
Well experienced.
Yeah. So I think the best part is, I got to agree with you guys, is that serving with people of varying ages and just seeing how eager they are to serve. It's like incredible to me.
Yeah.
Like I've never seen that before in my life. The other thing is that we actually embrace technology here. Like we don't shy away from it.
Mm-hmm.
And like NatFest shows exactly what we're capable of. And I think that was awesome.
Yeah. Agreed. Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. It was pretty incredible this year for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Dave.
Yeah. My favorite part is definitely just getting to be with these people. Mm-hmm. The team atmosphere and dynamic has just been such a joy. Many of the team members over the years have become my close friends, and that's always been a delight. And then just getting to see, like, I'll just use it, last couple of years at NatFest, the young people doing lights, and like this year was Ruben and Brandon, and the joy and excitement when the lights worked right.
That's right.
And it all went perfect, and they're high-fiving and they're so excited, and you know, I get to high-five them too and get to be part of that with them, just because, you know, trying to encourage them throughout the way. And that's a real delight. But my second and very close to first favorite is also the evolution of where we've come.
Yeah.
I had a fence board on a basketball net at Jordan Public School that was about 20 feet long with a projector that I bungee corded to the end of it every Sunday morning. And we would shoot that onto just a white cinder block wall, painted white cinder block wall.
Yeah.
And we've got four projectors now and amazing like camera work happening. And the audio is nowhere near what it was like in a concrete box at Jordan Public.
Yeah.
And, you know, graphics are on point every week and lights are on point. It's just such a delight to look back and laugh at the funny things that we've done and the hilarious things we've done. And we still do that.
There's
still times where like Len and Peter and I are cobbling something together so we can have five cameras for NatFest. And we kind of had to, you know, pull out what we could to make that happen. And even Tovey and I had to pull out all the stops on stage to make NatFest happen, because we only have a 32 channel board and we were running 33 channels and we're trying to like, how do we do whatever we can with the technology we have?
Yeah.
And like that spirit of like, use whatever you got to do the best we can.
Yeah.
And then if we can get better technology, let's get it and do even better and limit and push that to limit.
Right.
Yeah.
And not letting, I guess, the technology limit what joy we have along the way. And at the same point, having our team grow with the technology, as Len said, we get to train people into even better technology too.
Right.
And that just constant, you know, excellence has been a real delight.
And I'll just add to that. So the collaboration for this year for NatFest was just outstanding, because there was, like what you said, we're trying to figure out things, and also trying to, having the screens on this year with camera coverage was the first time that we did it. And we wanted to ensure that, all those challenges, because there, and some inherent challenges with that. For example, if the lighting guys want to put green on there, well, green isn't very flattering color on the face, right? Yeah, so when we put up people with green, they're going to... Mm-hmm. So
we had
it's
a good Smurf shot for a while there.
Right.
So we, you know, worked with Ruben Brandon.
But it was a great, just on that point, like those guys are so dedicated and put so many hours in for that lighting presentation. But it was a great opportunity for us to now get them to think a little bit differently. Like, you can do an experience in the room for the people there, but we're actually shooting this for the screens in addition to online.
Yeah.
And you have to take into consideration the camera and the colors and what that looks like for the external audience that this is eventually going to get to. But it was wonderful to collaborate with those guys, in particular the lighting guys, because they were very passionate, caring, but also very receptive to go, that's wonderful, but you got to tweak it a bit, and here's the reason and rationale why. And they responded really well. So that's, again, just to add to like the youth and the training and the collaboration that goes on is outstanding.
Yeah, I think there's a beautiful thing that happens when you get a group of people who are dedicated to moving in the same direction, Yeah. You know, the collaboration, it happens because there's a humility there amongst everyone because you're all there serving together, moving in the same direction. And it does build a bond. Like you talked earlier about like how, you know, some of your closest friends now are people you've served on tech with. And that, that is kind of a deliberate thing that happens when you're intentional about serving together. And I see it a lot in the tech team because you guys, I mean, you guys dedicate a lot of time that people don't realize, right? You know, to what you guys do. And it's, yeah, it shows in the way you guys interact on a Sunday. And, you know, even when things go sideways, like there's a joy there that I think only comes when there's an intentional serving together on purpose with purpose. So I appreciate that about your guys' team. It's pretty awesome. And speaking of purpose, actually, my next question is a very personal one. And it's it has to do with this idea, you know, what is your personal purpose for serving on the team? Like, I know we all like tech. I don't think we'd be sitting here if we didn't like tech. But I think it probably goes deeper than that. And I would love to hear from you guys. Like, what is your personal purpose in serving? And maybe, Peter, I'll get you start here.
Yeah, so my personal purpose is that I've always learned to use my talents in a meaningful way to serve others. And I find it gives me great joy just to do that. It also helps that, yeah, I'm passionate about music and tech. And I've actually been doing it probably for over 40 years in some way or another.
Yeah.
And I still find it, you know, relevant and I like doing it. And yes, I am probably the oldest member on the team. So,
yeah. The cool part is Peter comes in with like that much experience and is humble enough to say, wherever you can use me, I want to be used. Right. Yeah. That's how all of our team members really approach it. I think that's a really beautiful spirit that many people enter into.
Right. Mm, agreed. Absolutely. Sid.
I think for me, like before I even started serving on tech, when I was like watching the services and stuff, I always found it easier to kind of just focus on worshiping God and just kind of being with him when the tech went smooth and there was no kind of things that I was noticing, like the lights going crazy or, you know, the graphics or whatever. And so now that I'm able to help like this run smoothly for people who are just trying to worship God and kind of be with him without making it distracting, I think is the main reason I do it.
Yeah, that's awesome. I appreciate that. Ephraim. Mm-hmm.
So for me, I joined the tech team just sort of for fun almost. My youth leader at the time got me into it. He, you know, walked me through. He was great. So much fun. I had a great time serving on tech team. But over the year or so that I've been doing this, I've realized that it's more of helping others learn about God and knowing that there might be someone out there that comes back for my lights or whatever, or comes back for the amazing cameras that we have, you know, and knowing that I can make a difference in that and I can make a difference in someone's life that maybe doesn't know Christ very well.
Yeah.
And just being able to change their life through the tech that we do.
The cool part, Ephraim, is, and I talk about this with Sarah all the time, is like, if your lights aren't on point, I don't mean just not on, but on point, it distracts from what the cameras are trying to do.
Right. Right.
And so like all of us working together create that excellence level
right.
and allows each of us to kind of shine in our what we're doing. And yet Len suffers when your lights suck. Right.
Right. Right. Yeah. Right.
So like,
right.
That's a cool part about it. Like, yeah, your lights also, enhance the camera work and the camera work
Absolutely.
Enhances the lights. And it's beautiful work we get to do together.
Yeah. Mm, agreed. Len.
I mean, I'm going to just add on what was just said. So for me, it's we were at a previous church during COVID when COVID first hit, and they had no production at all, no technology there. So I volunteered to do it. And I would work tirelessly just to make it perfect because I knew that the impact that a sermon has on people, because I know when we first started to go to church, how much church impacted us as a family and certainly changed the way that we thought, believed, the way that we acted as people. It was very transformational, and I never take that for granted.
Mm-hmm.
And when we were at that other church and putting all that effort in, one of the pastors happened to say, Len, you're putting too much effort. It's just church. And that was incredibly hurtful on so many levels that my perspective is, well, it is church, and I should put this level of detail. And I had a 180-degree different thought about what that is.
Mm-hmm.
And I really like it here because... we've been here for over a year and a half now and been volunteering for a while in the tech team, is that the people here, even before we got here, valued the technology and saw that it's purposeful.
Yeah.
And it's evolved since I've got here. We have the screens on all the time now. And I truly believe that is impactful just because of what you previously just said, was if there's a new person coming in the door, I always think about that person, and they're going to be apprehensive. They're going to be at the back of the room. They may not be right at the front because they're new and they're nervous. Mm-hmm. But what can we do on the screens? Everyone's got a screen in their pocket now, and we're all conditioned to look at screens, digital signage systems, TVs at home. People are going to be watching those screens. So what can we do as a team to engage somebody that more effectively, that brings them back week after week? And that's tighter camera shots. That's putting the screens on mm-hmm. the entire time. So it's not just text for something to read, but you want to see the emotion of the pastors talking. You want to see the emotions of the people for the baptisms. So to have that ability to sort of influence some change and kind of go, what, let's do it differently. Let's do it with more passion and more feeling and emotion. When those new folks do come in, then they can feel what we already feel as a congregation, that this is our home mm-hmm. and I want to come back week after week and serve and be part of this wonderful church at New Hope.
Ah, so good, man. Thank you.
Yeah. What Len said, like when that was educational for me when he joined mm-hmm. and he shared that with Toby and I, and I went, oh, he's so right. We have to change how we do things. And like this Sunday to see the people coming to the baptism tank and their face projected so well on our new projectors and mm-hmm. with the cameras that are decent, not as good as the ones that were coming in a few weeks. They've been coming for a few weeks for the last 3 months.
Sunday. Right.
But like that will be even closer then. Mm-hmm. But it does add for that person at the back, because now we're feel right to the back and those people need to be able to connect. And it really does draw you in. It's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
For myself.
Yeah.
Thanks, Len, for helping change my opinion on things too, and growing me in that as well. It's been amazing for me. I have two verses that have kind of kept me in the last, I think it's almost been 20 years of mm-hmm. doing this at New Hope. And Romans 10 verse 14 to 15 says, how then can they call on the one they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? And how can anyone preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. And so on that, I feel that, you know, the pastors can get up there and preach, and the 500 people with a baby's crying won't hear unless we get to do or see mm-hmm. or get to be drawn in unless we get to be there and do what we do. And it's, I know it's just 500 or 400 and something per service, but I mean, there's expounded by three and soon to be expanded by four.
You got it.
And then the very first verse when I was a little, like very young, a little boy, I feel like it was 20 years ago. I was just a poor little 17-year-old, was Isaiah 43:5. So a voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level and the rugged places plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed and the people will see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. And I've always felt like that was my kind of tech, that mission statement. We will raise the valleys and lower the mountains. It removed the distractions that people can then clearly hear and see and worship. And and the Holy Spirit can do its thing in their hearts. And that's been my main purpose. And obviously I love leading a team. Otherwise I wouldn't be doing this for so long.
That's right.
I get a lot of joy out of that as well. But my purpose are those two verses. And that's also our, in case everybody doesn't know, those are our tech mission statement as well.
Right.
I shared that with you guys at the tech thank you party last year, but I didn't know if everybody got to hear it. So
no, it's good. Thank you for sharing that. I appreciate that a lot. A lot of work goes into leveling the ground for people, and you guys are in the trenches doing it. So thank you for that. And, you know, talking about leveling the ground, we are going to four services. And, you know, it's funny because for the congregation, you know, we're doing our very best for them not to feel that, right? Like as a staff, as a team, we're planning that out, going like, how do we, just so you don't feel like you're being ushered out. It's why we spent money and time to put a 6,000 square foot tent up to make lobby space and all those things, right? But at the end of the day, like on the back end, it is felt. And I would argue that I think tech is probably going to feel it as much, if not more, than some of our other ministries, because, you know, where most of our ministries have shift changes and things like that. I mean, you know, whoever's in that crow's nest on the camera is in that crow's nest on the camera for all four services, you know, and we're reducing our time between services. So there's, you know, no time for pee breaks. Like it is a slog. It is an endurance run.
You can't get to the bathroom anyway.
That's right. Yeah, right. It's the hall.
It's not, you can't get through the hall.
For the record, I did actually put a bathroom in the new plan just for those servings.
Oh, beautiful.
So nice. We got a space.
Like right in the tech booth? Because I'll be
almost.
Weird.
Almost. You'll have clear access to it. I planned it out. It was good.
Thank you.
But you know, in the midst of that, what I love is you talked earlier about, you know, you have this joy in serving, and I know you guys are joyfully going into this going, yeah, okay, we'll do it.
Mm-hmm.
What are you guys most excited about with four services coming? Like, what's the thing you're like, this is going to be really fun, or this is gonna be crazy and awesome. And you know, and Len, maybe I'll get you started out on this one.
On the simplistic side, it's good for us because we need a few rehearsals. So not to say that the first group gets shortchanged, but it gives us an opportunity to sort of get the kinks out. So if you come to the last serve, it's going to be awesome.
Oh, yeah. No,
it's going to rock. Yeah, it's going to be fantastic. So, I mean, there is honestly some truth in that, right? Mm-hmm. Because we have to see and hear everything before, because we don't get a dress rehearsal, right? So we see mm-hmm. the first thing. For me, I could care less because it really doesn't add to your day. It is another service, but it doesn't really make it necessarily that longer.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of look at that and go, more people, the better, because I take pride in the work that we're doing up there.
Yeah.
There, it is purposely driven.
Mm-hmm.
We're just not there for, we're not eye candy. It really is a purposeful support method for the pastors and the worship team. And again, like what I said earlier, I think that what we can do makes people feel more when they're in the room. Mm-hmm. And I take that with such great pride. And to me, if that means we have four services because we have more folks, bring it on.
Yeah.
Because ultimately it's great for everybody. On the tech side, again, we'll handle it. It's not really a longer day. It's one more service, but it really doesn't add much to it.
Yeah.
And we get the kinks out. So by the end, it's awesome.
That's a bonus. Absolutely.
Well, really, that four service is going to rock.
It will.
It really will. I'm not joking.
Yeah. The band's better. We're better.
We're all tuned up. And
yeah. And everyone goes, it's the last one. We got nothing to lose. And everyone's relaxed. And it's good.
It's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Maybe Dave, I'll get you to jump into this one. What are you most excited about?
Yeah. I guess I'm just, I love spending time with this team.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't like the waiting between services. It makes me anxious, because mm-hmm. we got things to do. Like, let's get going. And there won't be that anymore. We're just gonna be going from one to the other, so it'll just be staying in that groove of like, here we go, let's go. And you know, obviously I'm pumped that more people are gonna get to hear and see, and maybe there'd be a little bit less jostling of chairs bumping into the camera tables because there's more room. But I think that'll only be temporary.
Yeah, you got it.
But thank you, Gord, for building us a second crow's nest. So now there'll be hopefully less jostling at that table, at least. But yeah, I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I think it's going to be that high adrenaline for the whole morning instead of these weird dips and lulls. And for me, it is high adrenaline. The stress of making sure that the recording and everybody's in their places and we're good to go is high. So I'd like to just stay there and let's just rock it right through. Right. So I'm looking forward to that.
Sweet.
It's going to be fun.
Efren.
What I'm looking forward to is seeing how many more people we can hold in these services. Cause if we're having a few hundred people in each service, adding one more service, you know, you're adding a significant amount of people, and each of these people, what is it, 200, 300 around?
Yeah, you can keep
each
going
of these people,
you can go a little higher.
I'll say 400. Each of these people have their own story, and each of these people need to hear the gospel.
Yeah, you got it.
And you can do that with these four services.
Yeah. Absolutely.
And maybe there'll be future tech members in there too.
That's
there
right. Yeah. That's right. The workers are in the harvest is what we're discovering. So that's good. Sid.
I think, like just kind of what Dave was saying about the like time in between services, kind of when you're in that mode of like, let's do it, let's, you know, get this done, let's do it well, without having that pause in between, is going to go, I think, a lot smoother, hopefully. And just, like you said, like kind of keeping you in that headspace for the whole time.
Absolutely. That's cool. Peter.
Yeah, I think everybody kind of covered it. I'm just looking forward to serving more people and you know, hopefully more fruit will be put out there. And I'm also looking forward to the time when we do have the new sanctuary, though. Like that's going to be really, really cool. But for now, this is going to be good.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I'm also ecstatic for the new sanctuary, not because we'll have less services, but because of this new speakers, the new lights,
right. Yeah. It's gonna be
shiny.
Know,
the new
gear.
Stuff.
Yeah, the new gear.
Yeah. Good point, Len. Yeah.
Yeah. We start to geek out. It's good.
Yeah, let's not go there. We'll lose everybody that's listening.
That's right. No, it's good. It's good. The last question is actually kind of a two-parter that I want to put you guys in it. The first part is, you know, with Four Services, what do you guys kind of foresee as the most challenging part for you as a team? But then the second part of that question is, how can the congregation support you guys in this as you're kind of navigating these new challenges of Four Services and tech and all those types of things? You know, it's a little more involved of a question, but not everybody has to answer that. But I would be curious to hear from you guys on that a little bit. And maybe Dave, I'll get you started on this one, man.
Our congregation is fantastic. Mm-hmm. Regular basis, people come to me and encourage me on the mix, specific things that they liked about it. Thankful for the work the team is doing. I guess my ask would be just do that to the rest of the team as well. Like,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. I need to do a better job of introducing the team more often. It's going to be really hard when we're at Four Services. That's I don't right. think I'm gonna be able to do that. But just, you know, the camera operators are pretty easy to find and the rest of us are up in the booth. And if you have something positive or specific encouragement for any one of the team members, I think that would be, it goes a long way.
Yeah.
I know there's a few guys that almost always come and say to me, Dave, that mix was great. Or Dave, were you happy with how the recording went? And just other members other than my team, asking how things went it's just nice to know that people care. Right.
Yeah.
So I think that encouragement can go great for I don't know if that's happening for the rest of my team. I know. I hope it doesn't and hope it could, you know, spread a little bit more. They are going to be here at 6 and all the way till 1 working and serving the whole time with very little breaks.
Mm-hmm.
And they're also going to be hungry and thirsty. So those are the other things I can think of. And we might need to get better stools for our people on the cameras.
Yeah, we'll invest in that.
If they're going to be working the whole time, and you get to sit, I feel bad for them, you know.
I stand during the sermon. That's fine. I can still serve it.
Awesome. Len, go ahead, man.
Yeah, I don't know if I have much to add to that. I mean, I think it's going to be a great opportunity again for us for Four Services. For me, kind of along what Dave said, it would be great to hear feedback. You know, we'll hear if it's too loud, or Dave will hear on the flip side when it's an awesome mix. But just, you know, do they like what we're doing? Do they like them? Because I try to change up camera shots, again, for the in the sanctuary audience, but also for the folks at home so they can get a different perspective. I try to get shots of the audience near the end when we do the benediction or if there's a baptism so people can see all the folks at the front. There's some intentional shots, right? We go wide initially if we see the congregation really engaging with hands up or they're moving. And so just some feedback on if they like the presentation. I know you can look at the numbers of views online, but for the folks here in the room when they're actually live, do you like what we're doing?
Yeah.
I mean, everyone's got an opinion, but it would be nice to hear that feedback.
Mm-hmm.
Even if there's just one thing you really liked, just tell us that one thing.
Yeah.
Like, just be that one specific encouragement that you enjoyed that Sunday.
Yeah,
right?
Fair enough criticism. You guys are whatever.
Yeah.
The camera shakes too much or whatever. You know, whatever that is.
Blame I'm just Matt. He bumped into the table five times.
I keep bumping with chairs, man.
But that that's it. And then, you know, Four Services means we may need more people. So if there's more folks, you can look around the room. It's quite an age gap between the folks that are just sitting here doing the podcast.
That's right.
So we're welcome to have anybody at any age, any ability, happy to train, happy to have someone who is experienced. Mm-hmm. So if there's anyone else that wants a shot at learning some technology and hanging out with some fun people, we're here.
Awesome. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, actually going with that, I've had multiple times where people have come up to me and say, hey, that was great. Mm-hmm. You guys are doing an awesome job. So it's not just you, Dave. It's like
awesome. Good. I'm glad other people
are getting that too.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think the most challenging part, hopefully, is that we don't get burned out doing it. But not just for us, but I mean, even the band and
pastoral
pastors
right,
too.
Right,
like,
right.
Yeah.
I'd be more worried about them because like we're normally here for that many hours anyway. So it's not a big deal. But
preaching four times and playing four times has got to be very hard.
It takes it out.
Yes.
Yeah.
For sure.
I'm nervous for them.
Mm. No, that's fair. Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, something I've thought about and might be an issue going from half an hour between services to 15 minutes.
Yeah.
It's nice for us because we can stay in the zone, whatever, but getting everyone out, not that it's a bad thing that everyone's talking. I love that everyone's talking, but getting everyone out and the new crowd in might be a little tight because still with half an hour, we're you know, we're starting services with, you know, 50% capacity, and then people are still coming in late because, you know, we got too many people, not enough space, which is a great thing that we have people, but going from cutting our time in half now is something I'm curious to see how this works out with getting the congregation out, getting the new crowd in. Yeah, just seeing how that works out.
Yeah.
Matt's got whips and hot irons.
He's going to start at the front.
Megaphones. Sorry,
cattle prods, right?
That's right.
You start at the front and you start.
It's funny you say that, though. We actually, because we've been talking and planning and processing four services for months. And actually, Breakfast with Santa was kind of a beta test to see how it functionally worked. And you guys didn't even know you were in a beta test, but you were.
Right.
And it was good. And I think it will be. It'll be a fun challenge for sure. The beauty in it is that God's provided crazy space for us that we should
awesome tent.
Yeah, we shouldn't have that. Like, who has a heated floored tent? Like, God is crazy. Yeah. You know, and it's this beautiful reminder that, like, as big as our imaginations can be, when we give that to God, He can go bigger.
Right.
You know, and it's beautiful and it's awesome and crazy. But Sid, I didn't want to forget you there.
I think in terms of challenges for the tech team, it'd be like getting up earlier. I mean,
that's fair.
Although it's only like half an hour, you know, we're already up pretty early, but I think, you know, there's coffee, there's things to keep you up. So, and for the congregation, I think we have a pretty great kind of congregation. I don't think there's anything really that they could do to improve.
Mm-hmm. Oh, awesome. Guys, thank you so much for taking the time out to join me on the podcast. It's been so good. And I mean, I could sit and talk with you guys all day. So,
okay.
You know, I'm for it. I don't know how anybody else will talk as I know about it, but it's good. You know, it is so good to hear a little bit, just a glimpse into how you guys are serving. And like you said, Len, for those interested, we legitimately would love to hear from you. In fact, you can stop any one of our tech team on a Sunday. You know, Dave's always running around with the iPad, so you can always, you know,
you find me.
So you can find him. That's right.
Or just come to the booth.
Yeah, or come to the booth.
You want a tour? You want to understand anything?
You got it.
You know, dip your toe in it, then by all means, come.
Absolutely, we'd love to have you there. If you're new to the podcast, or new to New Hope, I'd encourage you to jump on our website or jump in our app and fill out a connect card, because we would love to connect with you. But we'll talk to you next time on Digging Deeper.